Greetings everyone, it's Thomas Moonigle. This month I'm going to be talking about manifesting in general. So it's not going to be a shifting video, but it is going to be a video to sort of help you get into the practice of manifesting better. And one of the things I'd like to talk about is, you know, working on the practical side of things. So there is of course the energetic side of things, and that's very important as well. But one of the things that you want to do as you're trying to manifest something, whether it's a new relationship, a new career, a new home, a new car, anything material or opportunity-wise, is you want to make sure that you're taking steps in your everyday life. And what I mean by that is, when I first started my business, I was watching The Secret, I was looking at a whole bunch of Law of Attraction things, and that was great, but I wasn't doing much else. So I would meditate, I would visualize, and then I would sort of sit and nothing would happen. And part of that was because there was just no way for stuff to reach me. At that time, I did not have a website, I did not have a business account, I did not have an accountant, I didn't even have PayPal set up. So I was just, you know, expecting people just to come drop out of the ether and find me, and then I would set all that up. So in order to have a business, to have a space like this, I'm in my office right now, I had to do certain things. One of the things I had to do, you know, when I went and I journeyed on it, I went and spoke to spirit guides and they said, get a website. I didn't know how to build a website. I didn't know what provider to go with. But until I did that, nothing was happening. And so I did. I went, you know, I got a website. And then they were like, get an accountant. So I had to go get an accountant. Well, I found to get an accountant and to have a business account set up at my bank, I had to go get a license, a business license from the city. So I had to go do that. You know, so I was getting guidance and I was getting help, but along the way I had to do some very mundane things. Setting things up with the bank, setting things up with finding an accountant and explaining my business and, you know, giving them all the information that they needed to set things up so that I was okay and legal. And then putting together a website. And for those of you that saw my first website, you know that it looked like monkeys put it together. But it was a functioning website. It may not look like much, but it actually worked. And so, you know, that happened. And, you know, I had my YouTube's videos were out by then. And I had some shifting videos up. And so I was starting to get attention. But now I was actually able to direct people to my website. So I had to learn to do things like put links in the bottom of the video that takes you to my blog, that takes you to my webpage. I had to set up PayPal donate buttons. These are all actions that I had to take that were not just sitting and meditating. I do sit and meditate. I do, you know, do energetic things to manifest, but I also have to build the roads for that energy to come back and reach me. So that's the trick about manifesting, is that you have to, you know, basically decide what it is you want, put it out there, but you also have to make sure that it has a pathway to follow to reach you. So it's like, you know, trying to build a home, but there's no road there. Until there's road there, you can't get materials to build the home. And so that's very important. I think it's very much glossed over in a lot of Law of Attraction commentaries. I think the Law of Attraction is very useful and good, but I think a lot of people gloss over the practical steps that you have to take. So, and sometimes those practical steps will drop right into your conscious of what you need to do, and you just have to follow along. Sometimes you have to look for them or you have to think about them. And it's really important. You've got to take practical steps. You have to build the road for things to reach you. So you have to build the path, and then you can allow stuff to flow to you. So that's kind of my tips on manifesting, is A, know what you want, see what practical steps you have to take. See if there's anything that's in your way right now that you can deal with and clear away to clear a path to you. So I will say this, after I did all the things that I was told to do, after I did all my homework, within just a few days of that, someone called me who I had not heard from in years, and they flew me out to the coast to do readings for them. They put me up in a beautiful hotel, the nicest place I've ever stayed. I was treated like a king, and it was wondrous, and I love it, and I would love to do that again. But I just was really brought home to me, if you do the work and if you follow through and are doing what you need to do in this world, on this plane, that's when the magic really happens. So it's not just energetic, it's not just mundane, it's the two together that really will bring in change. And the other part of this is that you yourself have to be willing to change or have to be willing to do things that you haven't done before. And that can be the trickiest part of all. But if you get that, stuff will happen. So I hope this is helpful to you. If you have any comments, questions, leave them down below. Please like, subscribe, and share on social media. If you'd like to book a private session with me, my link will be down below for my website. You can also, you know, catch up what I'm thinking because I write a weekly blog. And you can also purchase my book on Amazon, Drumming Down the Runes, Walking the 24 Roads. You can get that in as a Kindle version, or you can get it as a print version. And you can also get an electronic book copy and ebook on the Nook at the Barnes & Noble website. So, there I'm doing all my homework for manifesting. Peace and blessings.